Hello. In this video, we're going to be looking at running VIM, which is a text editor, and the GCC compiler from within the Windows command line. The first thing we'll need to do is navigate to the VIM website. And from here, you're going to want to go to the download section. Click on the PC MS-DOS Windows. The file I recommend running is the gvim82.exe. So go ahead and click that and save it. Open up your downloads folder. You should have your file, gvim82.exe. Go ahead and double click that to start the install. Click on next, accept the license agreement, next. You can just go ahead and accept the defaults for now. Click next. You can change this, but I'm just going to install it in the recommended default. Okay, it's completed. And here you got some icons. You can have a GUI version of it. I'm just going to delete these for now. Okay, and the next thing we're going to want to do is add VIM to our system path so that we're able to access it by the command line. Easy way to do that is just open up Windows Explorer, right-click on the My PC icon, click on Properties, and over on the left here, click on Advanced System Settings, and down here, click on the Environment Variables button, and that opens up the window that we want to edit in. So what we're looking for, we can just go ahead and add it to the User Variables path. So up here, Highlight Path, we're going to want to edit that. Click on New, and we can browse. And the default location is going to be C drive, Program Files, VIM, and the VIM82 folder. Click on OK. Make sure it looks like this. And as long as we're in here, why don't we go ahead and add our GCC executable to our path as well. So go ahead and repeat the process. Click on New. We're going to browse, again in our C drive, and code blocks is actually a 32-bit program, so that's going to be in the program files, x86. Put up code blocks, we want the min, GW, and the bin folder. That's where the compiler resides. So click on OK, so make sure it looks like this. Then go ahead and click on OK. You can just OK out of all these windows you open. Now we'll go to the command line and check it out. Just type in CMD. It opens up. This is called the command line, command prompt or console window. There's various names, and I'll probably use them all, but basically it's a console window. So the first thing we can do is just type VIM. And there you go. So we got VIM accessible now by the command line. To exit VIM, just hit the colon and Q. Then we also want to check see if our GCC compiler is installed. So check that, do GCC version. GCC 2- and version. And hit enter. And as long as you got this, you should be set up and ready to go. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and test to make sure GCC can compile. To do that, we're going to use VIM to edit our files. But first, notice that by default, usually in your home directory, so let's create a couple of directories to hold our projects. To do that, you can use make directory command in Windows, and there's two ways to do it. Make directory or MD in Windows. So let's just go ahead and make a folder called something like projects. And then we're going to have to change directory into it. So just type change directory, your folder name, whatever you call it. Let's make a new directory. So make directory, and let's call this hello. And again, we'll change directory into hello. And if you do like a directory dir command right away, you'll notice that zero files in there right now. Of course, since we just created it. So let's go ahead and edit the source code. So do vim, V-I-M. Let's just call it hello.c. So just like that. Go ahead, hit enter. Now we're inside the Vim editor. And if you never used Vim before, you'll notice if you try typing, nothing happens. And that's because we're in what's called normal mode or command mode. And Vim's got two main modes that we're going to work with, normal and insert. In order to get to insert mode, you're going to have to hit the I key. If you notice down here, we're now in insert mode. So now we can type text like normally. So let's just go ahead and build a simple program. And we'll need to include a file. This is a C. We'll have to use a standard IL.h. And of course, we'll need a main function. Opening, closing bracket, bracers. Okay, and since we're using C, we'll have to use printf, or print formatted. Let's just create a little string here. Let's add a return. That should be good. Now to save a file in Vim, you have to hit the escape key once. Notice down here we're in insert mode now. You hit the escape key once, we're back into normal mode. Then hit the colon. If you look down here, this is called last line mode. The colon's going to prefix our command. Then W and Q. So that's going to write and quit the file, or save and quit. And go ahead and hit enter. Now if you do DIR again, you should see our Hello C source code file. And I believe this one up here is just a buffer from Vim, but the one we're worried about is this. So let's go ahead and try to compile it now with the GCC compiler. So type GCC. Let's give it some flags for the compiler. Capital W-A-L-L, kind of like wall. But what it actually stands for is warnings all, show all warnings. That's helpful if you mistype something in your source code. Kind of gives you a indication of what's happening. Now we need to give it our source code file, which is hello C, just like this. Then do a minus O for output. And just give the name that we want our final file to be, in this case, hello. Windows will automatically throw the exe on there, so just type it like shown here, then hit enter. If everything compiles and runs fine, it should be just like this. If you got errors or mistype something, it would show some errors, warnings in here, just like in code blocks. So go ahead and fix them until it compiles like this. I'll just go ahead and hit DIR, and you should see both our source code file and our new hello executable file. So in order to run the executable file, just go ahead and type hello and enter. And since this is just a command console, there it is, sandwiched. I didn't add any new lines or anything to fancy it up. This is just a basic test, because we've been through this all before. Now we can also create a C++ file just to test that too. I'm sure it will work fine, but just for completeness. Let's go ahead and make a new file. Let's call it hello2. In this case, just name it CPP, just to differentiate it. And again, hit the I for insert key. Again, we're going to want to make an include file. Since this is a C++, we'll do a file stream. Main function. Okay, and since this is C++, we can just use the standard cout that we're used to with the code blocks. And give it a string. Okay, and of course, return 0. And there we go, simple hello world program. So again, hit escape key, colon, W, Q, so right quit, hit enter. Look in our directory now. You should have a hello2 CPP file or source file. And now to compile this, use G++. That's just the C++ version of the compiler. Again, we can use the same flags. And this time, the source file is going to be L2.cpp. Then we do again minus O for the output file. And we just call it hello2. So go ahead and hit enter. And again, assuming you have no errors, you should just return the prompt. So I'm going to run it. Hello2. And there we go. Spelling and all. Okay, so hopefully that was a quick overview, but it's enough to get you up and running using both Vim and the compiler from the command line. And I do have a written tutorial pretty much going over the same thing on the website that I'll link in the description below. So thank you for watching and see you in the next video.